This review is going to be kind of awkward, but what I do have here, I don't have a script for this video. I have Lego Star Wars Armored Marauder. We're going to have the box, it's already awesome. Set 75311, 478 pieces for ages 8 and up. So this is very awkward. But let's go ahead and open and build it. Cool. Watch this. Alright, so here it is, right out of the box. Comes with four figures. We have the artillery trooper, basically just a regular stormtrooper painted in yellow. It's got a little pauldron and a backpack. And with it, it doesn't come with a gun, but instead it comes with this mortar that you build in the first bag. Next, two stormtroopers, you know, basic stormtroopers, with the really awkward helmet. This is really awkward. And then it comes with one of the Mandalorian's main characters, Greef Karga. There we go. I can't remember which side of my phone the camera's on, so. Yeah. And then onto the Armored Marauder itself. So let's move these figures out of the way real quick. Again, I told you, this is going to be the most awkward review I'll ever do. It's fine. Okay, so starting off with the way it looks. It's honestly kind of small compared to the box. But, you know, that's just how it is. It's got, let's see, four stud shooters and the little guns on the side that you can pull out. On the back here, you can open this door. You can put a little trooper in there. See if I can get him in there. Yeah, you can put him in there because there's a seat in there. You can open it, close it, you know. And then you can turn this side to side. It doesn't go full 360. Which is why I'd recommend taking that little piece. That wasn't supposed to happen, but I'd recommend taking that little piece off if you want it to go 360. I personally am just going to leave it like it is because I'm a nerd like that. And then up top, this opens. There's no actual function for that besides just looking like that. Just push it down like that. Over here, we got some little flaps with cargo inside. And I personally, you don't have to do this, but there, when I built it, I put a little green stud in there. You know, cargo, you know, and stuff. Yeah. Again, I don't have a script for this video, so. Let's see if I can get that back in there. This is really horrible. Like, not the set itself, this is a good set. I mean, like, the way this is going. Hold on. Okay, I got that. Let's close that. Now, moving on to the front. You can open this up. You can put a stormtrooper inside. I'm not gonna try, because I already tried it with the back. And it was too awkward for me to actually do. I say awkward a lot in this video. Editing, Aaron, if you could, would you put an awkward counter every time I say it? So you can open and close that, you know. Again, stud shooters, you know, you can... You all know how stud shooters work. Then, on the top there, there's a little door you can open. Shows a little spot. You can put two stormtroopers or any minifigure you want in those seats. But it's definitely a tight space. However, I have giant hands, so if you have smaller hands than I do, it should be relatively comfortable. On the side, both sides actually, it's got these little doors they can open and shut, and it just leads to the inside, making it a bit easier to get to those seats. You can see them back there. You obviously can't see it because it's really tiny. yeah, really crappy review from me, from my point. There's definitely better reviews on the tube. Again, this is my first review. So for this, like I said, I'd give it personally an 8.5 out of 10. I love the figs. I love the build. It just feels a little small and cramped. Anyways, that's been my first LEGO review on this channel, Star Wars at Random. Remember to subscribe and like the video if they thought this was okay. Again, it's really awkward, so, you know, just, yeah. May the Force be with you all, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.